What's up, guys? This is Matthias, aka Rulers Poker, and I'm right continuing from where we left off the last time. So now that we analyzed this hand, we can go ahead and search for some other hands. For example, we could take a look at what aces do here in general and then see if this pattern is repeating. And this is one option. All the other options are shown here. So we have the option to create a new spot, and this new spot will be created by using all the parameters on the left side. So we can have any board here, dependent on the high card. So for example, if we only want to practice check high boards, we could double click here on the check, and now we would only creating check high boards. To revert it, we can click here on the heading, which is quickly selecting or unselecting certain cards, or we can just go and remove and add the single cards. The rest is already set up as it is here. So we are 100 big blinds, 3-bet pots, out of position. Position is loose, which means that the preflop we have here small versus button. And if we would select tight instead, we would have a small versus under the gun situation. So we have single suited, unpaired board. The flop action was none, so there was no action yet. We are first to act for c betting. So as you can see, we can also practice, if you want to practice stabbing, so reacting to a check from the preflop aggressor, we would go ahead and just select the check here. Or we could also practice from the turn. So for example, if we want to practice delayed c-betting, we would be able to double click here. Or we can also just practice only flop or only turn like this. So we can select deselect here. And yeah, if you're getting lost somewhere, we can always click on the apply, which applies the current situation again. And we can also determine the turn transitions. So do we only want to practice blank turn cards or pairing turns, flushing cards, and so on. And last but not least, the difficulty, which is pretty much the harder you pick the difficulty, the harder the software will try to find hands that are mixed in its play. So yeah, that have like very mixed lines. So that's it about the difficulty. So yeah, these parameters would be taken and randomly a new spot would be generated out of these. If you're clicking on new spot, new hand will generate new hands in the current situation. So instead of the aces 9-6, we get a totally new hand. And the continuing is when we, yeah, if we're not interested only in whether we check or bet here, but also interested in what to do against the opposition. So now we are in the opponent's shoes and we can decide whether we want to check, whether we want to stab for half pot, or whether we want to randomize it. So yeah, let's consider aces 9-6. Is it interesting to think about what to do against the bet? Yeah, for sure. It's interesting. I'm sure there are also some interesting turn cards to take a look at. So we could also just go ahead and choose a random action. But for now, let's go ahead and let him bet. And I say that it is a fold now against the bets. And this is perfectly right. We can see it's always a fold. And again, we get the list of other ace-ace-9-6 we have here, other categories. So in order to call, we would need a backdoor nut flush draw or the blocker, the ace of hearts blocker, or a single heart, which is very close, 57 versus 43. Maybe we can get something out of the subcategories. So folding the most without a backdoor flush draw blocker and calling the most here with this type of hand. So we can see here's the category. Blocking the six of hearts should seems to be relevant here. So you can go into a lot of detail or just stay at a little bit more on the surface and consider that with a heart, this is going to be a mixed play.